Good evening, and welcome to my seventh Barry Manilow video blog. If this is your first time seeing one of my video blogs, there are six others, and you can find them on my Facebook page, Robert Benson's Barry Manilow's video blog page. Just ask to join and you can get in. Our first topic is this. So you meet a friend, or a kid, or a grandkid of yours, and you want to introduce them to the music of Barry Manilow. Well, most people want to hear an album before they, decide. You can always pick one good song, and they may not like the rest of their songs. So, if you could choose one album to be your pick to indoctrinate someone to Barry's music, which album would you choose? I've narrowed it down to three of my choices. Choice one would be the first Manilow album, the live one, where he's standing like this. It has many of the early hits, like Mandy and I Write the Songs. It has some obscure songs like Studio Musician. But most of all, it's live, so you get that added excitement. We all know Barry Manilow is probably, or we know, because the Rolling Stone magazine is always, right? He's the showman of our generation. That's a great album. For studio albums, I would probably use Even Now, because it, again, has a lot of the hits. Big hit album with Ready to Take a Chance. That's not on that album. That's on the Foul Play album. Ah, I caught myself. But it does have Even Now, Can't Smile Without You, Copacabana, Somewhere in the Night. But it's got some cool, like a jazz song, like I Was a Fool to Let You Go. It's a great album. Some people like concept albums. And Barry's been doing those recently. When I mean recently, 15 minutes and at the beginning of, 2001, I think, or he did the Mayflower. That would be my third pick, the Mayflower album. I like 15 Minutes, but I like Mayflower, too, because it has some great ballads. It's based on different people in an apartment complex. We all know the story. It's got some catchy songs, and because it has Freddie Said, that's why I picked that album. That's such a great song from Barry, so unlike Barry. My kids love Freddie Said. My favorite song on the album, surprise, is She Should Have Been Mine. It's a sad song. I love that song. But those are my three picks. So what would be your picks to introduce someone to the music of Barry Manilow? What is your favorite? Let's put it this way. What do you think are Barry's saddest songs? You know me, I like the sad songs. And again, I've narrowed it down to three. Oh, there are many more sad songs from Barry Manilow, Even Now, Starting Again. But here are the three. Here are the three that I think stand out. If I Should Love Again. I keep mentioning that song for other reasons, but I think that's his saddest song. Right up there with number two, How Do I Stop Loving You? Great song. It came on the Greatest Hits and Then Some, Greatest Hits and Then Some collection he did. I heard it at the concert many years ago. He put it on that album. That's a sad song. And also from the If I Should Love Again, I go with No Other Love. I love No Other Love. It's just this the story they meet. You think it's going to be a happy song, but when you get to the end, they're no longer together, but she's still his no other love. It's a sad song. I have to say that when I got that album, If I Should Love Again album, I probably cried. A couple of those songs are sad. What is your favorite Barry Manilow tour? Sometimes his tours are thematic. There was the Broadway album where he took his songs and he put them into like various plays, like instead of Phantom of the Opera, he sang Could It Be Magic. That's one of that really stands out to me. I also liked the tour for the Mayflower. That was a good tour. I liked the tour for the RCA album. There was a concert where he sang most of those songs before they came out. I love that tour. I liked the in the Round tour that he did. Great tour. And of course his Vegas gigs were good too. But what tour of his that you remember? How about the what was it, the big, the Tour de Force? Is that what it was called? The Tour de Force tour, the one from like the early 90s. I saw that one at the, or maybe that was the late 80s. I saw him at the Pantages Theater. First time I, as a driver, I drove out of San Diego. I was like, you know, 18 or 19. I drove to Los Angeles, which is always scary to drive to Los Angeles. And so our song of the day comes from the greatest hits from the 50s. And I picked this song because it was my grandparents' favorite song, When You're Young at Heart. Here it is playing right now. It's a happy song, and it's encouraging you to stay young, you know, not to take life so seriously, and, you know, live a life. You know, there's going to be ups and downs, and but the lyrics of this song are just so good, and I dedicate this to my grandma and grandpa who have passed away years back. But this, whenever I hear the song, I certainly think of them. And so let me hear your comments on today's theme of the song, today's song of the day. And if you have a suggestion for the song of the day, give it, and I'll give you a shout out. And that brings us to the end of another video blog. Let's hear a little more of this song. Okay, I got to end the video, but thank you very much, and we'll see you next time. And good night.